So I'm going to discuss about interrupts of 8051 microcontroller. Before going to discuss about the interrupts, let me give you the brief introduction to interrupts. A single microcontroller can solve several devices. In the interrupt method, whenever any device needs its service, the device notifies the microcontroller by sending it an interrupt signal. Upon receiving an interrupt signal, the microcontroller interrupts whatever it is doing and serves the service. The program associated with the interrupt is called interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. Interrupt service routine means for every interrupt, there must be an interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. When an interrupt is invoked, the microcontroller runs the interrupt service routine. For every interrupt, there is a fixed location in the memory that holds the address of its ISR. The group of memory locations set aside to hold the addresses of ISR is called the interrupt vector table, or we can call it as interrupt handler address. Now there are totally 6 interrupts which are associated with the 8051 microcontroller. First, let me discuss what are the interrupts associated with the 8051 microcontroller. We have 2 external interrupts and 2 timer interrupts and 2 serial communication interrupts, which is receive interrupt and transmit interrupt. Let us discuss now in clearly about the interrupts and their interrupt handler address. In reality, only 5 interrupts are available. Like as I said, only these are the 5, but if you count independently, again the serial communication, serial interrupt is divided into RI and TI, receive interrupt and transmit interrupt. So first one and one more is reset. When the reset pin is activated, 8051 jumps to the address location 0000. This is the power of reset. 2 interrupts are set aside for the timers. One for timer 0 and another one for timer 1, and memory locations are 000BH and 001BH in the interrupt vector table, which belongs to timer 0 and timer 1 respectively. And 2 interrupts are set aside for external interrupts, hardware interrupts, and which having the vector address of 0003H and 0013H in the interrupt vector table are assigned for INT0 and INT1 respectively. Coming to the serial communication interrupt, which is having both RI and TY, the interrupt handler address is set as 0023H. Then coming to IP register, interrupt priority register. So as we have discussed, we have total 5 interrupts, 2 external interrupts and 2 timer interrupts and 1 serial communication interrupts. Which interrupt is having highest priority? This is the sequence of the priority of the interrupts. According to the priority, it will execute. So the first priority is having the external interrupt 0 is having the highest priority. Next timer interrupt 0 is having the next highest priority. Next external interrupt 1, next timer interrupt 1, and the last priority goes to serial communication interrupt. So here interrupts will execute as per the priority levels. And coming to interrupt enable registers, the size of the interrupt enable register is also of 8 bit. So this IE register is used for enabling and disabling an interrupt. Upon reset, all interrupts are disabled, meaning that none will be responded to by the microcontroller if they are activated. The interrupts must be enabled by software in order for the microcontroller to respond to them. There is a register called IE register. So this IE register is responsible. This IE register is responsible for enabling and disabling, we can say that masking and unmasking the interrupts. So, and the very important point is the IE register is bit addressable register. So from this figure, it is noticed that bit D7 in the IE register is called the EA register. To enable the interrupts, we have to use this bit, and this must be set to 1 in order for the rest of the register to take effect. And this one D6 is unused. And even D5 is unused by 8051 microcontroller, but this is used by 8052 microcontroller. And this D4 bit is set for serial communication interrupt, and so on, like D3 for timer interrupt 1, and D2 for external interrupt 1, D1 for timer interrupt 0, and another one is D0 for external interrupt 0. Just let me discuss the steps in enabling an interrupt. To enable an interrupt, we have to follow the steps. Bit D7 of the IE register must be set to high to allow the rest of the registers to take the effect. If this EA is equals to 1, interrupts are enabled and will be responded to if their corresponding bits in IE are high. If EA is equal to 0, no interrupt will be responded to even if the associated bit in the IE register is high. So to access any of these interrupts, first we have to enable the D7 bit of IE register.